All right, we're just gonna ignore my hair. I could like fill in my hair to make it look more full in, but it's whatever. Who are we fooling here? You guys don't care, right? My hairline is just so weird. So I've been wanting to do this video for quite a bit. I was just kind of waiting until I got a few more things. So this is going to be my products I regret buying video. I haven't done one of these since like way, way back when. Like, don't even watch that video. Embarrassing video. I've watched like a lot of other people's and I know it's like completely, it stirs up stuff in people when they hear you talk about a product they love and you don't like it. It gets people angry. I don't know why. I don't know why people get so angry about such little things, but not everything works for everyone. Every video that I've seen so far, there's a little speech before, and you know, I'm not gonna do it. You guys already know basically what I'm about to say, so I'm not gonna say it. Here we go. Here's the products that I regret buying that didn't work for me that I would definitely not purchase again. Starting with number one. I did a video review on this actually. Wet n Wild Perfect Pout Lip Palette. So it's the prettiest thing ever. It's just a bunch of lip colors in little heart shapes. And if you watched my video on this, you know probably why I don't like it. It has literally 10% pigmentation. It has nothing. So yeah, I mean, demonstrate. It just like washes away as you apply it. So it's good for like a wash of color, but nothing really that I ever would use it for. I think it's really fun. I just don't have a need for it. It'd be awesome if they were pigmented because I love all the shades, but they all kind of wash to a natural lip color. So not a fan of this, would not repurchase. It even is a little bit sticky on the lips. It's kind of like, what did you expect? There's so many different colors and all that stuff. I didn't expect this to be like a crazy lip palette or anything that was gonna be like a holy grail, but a little disappointed that I couldn't even use like one shade. Number two, are you ready? This one I feel like is definitely gonna be up in the air with some of you guys because I had heard good things about it, but I just couldn't get it to work for me. This is the e.l.f. Flawless Finish Foundation. I can't take the smell. Like, just opening it. I don't not like, I don't even know. It just smells like super foundation-y. I don't know the term for it. It's not necessarily a chemical smell, but it's that smell if you were to think of a very strongly smelling foundation, that's what this smells like. And I had used it in a first impressions video and I said the same thing. And since then, I've reached for this like maybe once or twice to try and convince myself I could get some use out of it, but I can't use it. That's the same reason I don't use MAC lipsticks, is because I don't really care for the smell too much. I don't really know what that smell is, but I don't like it. This one smells a little bit better. It's almost like, not icing, but if you smell it too long, I feel like it doesn't smell as good as when you first smell it. This one sounds so weird, but smells really will put me off a product, especially a foundation, because I do use like not a lot of it, but it goes all over your face. When I used this before, the smell does just like dissipate from your face. Like, you don't smell it as much, but I just can't. It also, the foundation, it felt a little heavy on my face. It is, I think, like a full coverage, medium to full coverage foundation. So that could be why. But the one I use now, which is the LA Girl Pro Coverage HD Foundation, that does not feel like that to me. This one's just a little too heavy. Next one is the CoverGirl So Lashy Blast Pro. The brush is really interesting looking, and it actually had me pretty hopeful because there's a little ball at the end, and I don't know if you remember, I think it was like telescopic or whatever, the mascara. I loved it because it had the little ball which you could comb through. The problem with this is that it puts way too much product for me on the brush. You can see the end. That's how it comes out if you don't wipe it off, which I could wipe it off. All right, I took away the tail. But there's still just too much product on the end of the ball to really use it to separate anything. And then these things are kind of get it like a little bit messy when you're trying to comb through your lashes. So I was never a big fan of this guy. I do not like a mascara where I have to do two steps where I have to put the product on and then use a secondary like mascara wand or an empty brow brush to comb through my lashes to get rid of excess product. I hate doing that. I want a wand that can do everything, which I do have some that do that, but this one just did not do that. So not a huge fan, would not repurchase. And then last but not least, this is the one that I was most like, this might make some people mad. Because whenever I do a product I regret buying, or really before I say anything bad about a product, I look online to see if maybe I'm doing something wrong, if there's a way that you're supposed to be using it that I'm not doing, that kind of thing. I always look that up. So when I looked this next product up, I saw it had amazing reviews. There were definitely people that felt the exact same way I did, but there was a lot more that didn't, that felt like really good about this product. So I think it's just personal preference. This is the Tarte Glisten Cheek Stain. I had gotten this, I forget, was it Christmas time? It was like a $10 deal. You know when Ulta has those like $5, $10 deals. And of course, I jump at everything and I just like fill up my cart and I'll just like, I'll figure out how to use everything later. I'm kind of an impulse shopper on Black Friday. Was it Black Friday or Christmas? I forget which one. I did get this because it was a pretty peach and cheek stain, which I never really use cheek stains, but I was like, okay, this might be kind of fun. And it is freaking gorgeous in the tube. It is just this iridescent pink orange kind of color going on my skin. So it shows up like that, which I really do like the color of it. The problem is that it's very sparkly, which I should have known to begin with. And it blends out very, very sheer, which maybe it's my skin tone, but it takes multiple coats to show up on my skin. And I can't use it as I would use a regular blush just because of how it feels. It feels like a chapstick. You know how chapsticks are just a little bit sticky? That's how these feel going on. So they kind of like pull at your skin just a little bit, not like a ton. But when you have makeup on that hasn't been set yet, it can move it a little bit. And then not only that, once you have it on, you have to rub it in. This would be good if you're not wearing any makeup, but for me, I rarely, if I'm gonna go like makeup free or at least face makeup free, I don't worry about a blush. And I probably wouldn't wear a sparkly blush. So that's just basically the biggest thing for me. I'm not saying it's a bad product, but it didn't work for me and I don't think I would repurchase it again if it were on sale again. Okay guys, I literally packed up everything, had my camera put it away, and then I found one of the products I was going to include and I dislike it so much, I put everything back up. I put my lights back on, camera's back up because I have to show you this. If you like this, please let me know how you made it work because I do want to make it work, but I just can't. One of the worst products I think I've ever purchased. This is the Maybelline's Master Contour V. I don't remember how much it was, but I feel like it wasn't cheap because their Master Collection is a little bit more on the pricier side. Not like insane, but still. Basically, I did a review on this and I said what I thought would be wrong with it and ended up being completely true. The colors themselves are fine, and maybe that's how I'll make it work, by just taking a brush and using the colors of this. But if you don't know what this is, it is a highlighter and contour stick literally in one. I was explaining to somebody and I said, you know, highlighter, contour stick in one, and they immediately thought of course I would too, highlighter on one side, contour stick on the other, and they're like, oh, why is that so bad? And I was like, no, you don't understand, it's split in the middle. So this is it. If you guys saw that video, you know exactly what I'm talking about. This, you're somehow supposed to be able to use each side of it, but as you can see how concaved it is, or what do you call that, sloped, it is literally impossible to not get a nice little line of each. See that little concealer matte highlight? It like intercepted my contour, because if you don't hold this just right when you're drawing your contour line, it becomes part of it. I do not like the design at all, and it's a shame because I do like the contour color and the highlight color. I think that it's a really nice yellow color. It's like a yellow tone to it, so I really like that. And this is the contour right there. It's a little light for a contour for me personally, but it is a really good shade. I feel like I'm a nice natural shade. It's just baffling to me about how it was supposed to work, because eventually it's gonna get even worse. I do not recommend this product at all. Let me know what you guys think. Do you love any of these products? Do you also not like any of these products? There's just so many different skin types and how people use their makeup. Definitely some of these could work for people. Let me know what you guys think down below, and thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in my next video. Bye!